السلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه من والاه. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. سبحانك لا نحصي ثناء عليك، أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك، أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر وأنت على كل شيء قدير. حياكم الله وأهلا ومرحبا بكم. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما، وأن يجعل التفرق بعده تفرقا معصوما، وأن لا يدع فينا شقيا ولا محروما. Last night, alhamdulillah, we finished an idea which is about the way of rewards. And is that this believer going to face ajr in the hereafter or not? Do you remember? And we said, just to sum up, then to continue inshallah. بقول الله تعالى والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون. Now the most important thing we said last time is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is justice. Allah العدل. وقضى على نفسه. He ordained on himself that anyone does any good deed will be rewarded. كل من عمل خيرا صالحا جيدا طيبا يجازى به. ولكن تذكر شو قلنا؟ In my language, we said you have two locations to receive the ajr. Worldly life, hereafter. It's your decision where you would like to have them. If you want to believe in him, in his conditions, you have both houses, الدارين. If you refused him, you disbelieved in him, حكينا شو معنى disbelieve والكفر وكفر وغطى وكفر, you rejected him, yet he will reward you, بس where? In this dunya, and that's it. خلاص. وما لهم في الآخرة there is nothing for them in the hereafter. So it's not والعياذ بالله, let's not misunderstand Allah or misjudge Allah والعياذ بالله. Allah does not force me or he pushes me outside of his mercy. He's opening the door and he's giving me the decision. If I accepted, believed, reward there. If not, it's my problem. This happened in the context when we are talking about al-muttaqin wal-iman wal-infaq. Okay? الفكرة بالأمس اللي ختمنا فيها يا أحبة كانت حول التساؤل إنه لماذا لا يجازى أصحاب الخير في الدنيا إذا كانوا غير مؤمنين، لماذا لا يجازون يوم القيامة؟ قلنا الموضوع ببساطة، القرار عند الشخص، الله لم يلزمه لم يمنعه، الله أخذ عهدا على نفسه من عمل خيرا يجازى به، انتهى، بغض النظر مؤمن ولا غير مؤمن، وين؟ في الدنيا. إذا حبيت تنتقل للوكيشن جديد وتأخذ الأجر في لها كونديشن، الكونديشن حسب شروط الخالق اللي أوضعها، قال لك تؤمن في تحترمني تعبدني بشروطي أنا، ماشي تفضل. طب إذا أنا رفضت simply أنا اللي قررت إني ما أخذ، نقطة. فlet's this be clear because many youth they are asking this question, okay? Today, now والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون. Allah is praising now, which is by the way, this point is part of what we call the pillars of Islam. That those believers whom Allah praised just in the verse before, يؤمنون بالغيب، ينفقون، مهتدون، إذا ويؤمنون أيضا بماذا؟ بما أنزل إليك اللي هو الوحي القرآن وبما أنزل من قبلك. So in Islam, and this is something we should be proud of, that our faith is not complete if we do not believe in the previous messages. It's part of the complete line of Islam from Adam عليه السلام to we know in specific because Allah told us we know about the Torah of Moses عليه السلام. We know about the gospel of Jesus عليه السلام. We know about the Psalms of David عليه السلام. He is Zabur Dawood. We know about Suhuf Ibrahim, the scripture of Abraham. Apart from that, we don't know about others. But anything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we believe. Now the most well-known two things that still we are witnessing, some of them now, the Torah and the Gospel, our Torah, well, the Injil. So from one angle, our faith is not complete if we do not believe. But believe in what? We believe that the Torah was revealed at a certain time on a prophet whose name was Moses or Musa alayhi salam, and it's called At-Tawrah. At-Tawrah, by the way, Torah in Hebrew means the law. It's like the word Sharia in Arabic. Okay? It's a Hebraic word, means the law. Exactly like Sharia. What's the Sharia? Law. Once a Canadian lady, she asked me when she knew that I'm a Islamic studies professor in one of the government, I needed to know some kind of documents. When she knew my personality, she said, I want to ask you something. I have a big problem with Sharia law. I said, she's about 70 something, and a Canadian official lady. I said, do you know what's the meaning of the word Sharia? She said, no. I said, Sharia in Arabic means the law, the way, literally means the way. As a terminology, it means the way of the Prophet, which means the law of the Islam as the Prophet showed us. So what you are telling me that you have the problem with the law of the law. Sharia law means the law of the law. Then she came from Christian background. Then I asked her, this is, by the way, just a few days ago. This incident just a few days ago, maximum 2-3 weeks. Then I asked her, do you know what's the meaning of the Torah? She said, no. I said, Torah means the law. I said, unfortunately, the media, they are giving you that you have. What do you know about the Sharia law? She said, I know that. The only thing that I know, that you chop the heads and you cut, you get, and that's the only thing. But I don't blame you. I don't blame you, because the media, this is the only thing that you know. She said, you know, I said, let's be fair. If I judged you through the KKK, do you accept? She said, no. Do you know the KKK? Yes. Huh? Klu Klux Klan? They are one of the most well-known terrorist groups on earth, and they claim belonging to Christianity. They speak on behalf of Jesus Christ. They use the cross. I used to burn the black people in America alive, hang them. Up to this moment, they have a political party in their names. Now, KKK. They are terrorists, and they are quoting the Bible, by the way, and they are respecting and believing in Jesus Christ. I said, do they represent Christianity? She said, no. I said, okay, the same thing, we have bad people, they don't represent us, they don't understand our religion. She said, thank you. But we come back to وَالَّذِي يُؤْمِنُونَ بِمَا I'm talking about what is our attitude towards other scriptures. You have to believe that there was a Torah was revealed to Musa, and there is Injil that was revealed to Jesus. But do we believe, according to the Quran, that the nowadays scripture that we have, they are the original Torah and the original Gospel? The answer is, according to the Quran, no. Because in many verses, when Allah asked us to believe in that, He told us that what you have now has been changed. The hand of, and by the way, many Jewish and Christian scholars, they admit in this, by the way, especially the Christian scholars. It's not something that they deny, but they said it was changed, but those who wrote these things, they were supported with the Holy Spirit to help them to write it in a correct way. Regardless now, our points. Quran tells us you have to believe that there was a Torah and there was an Injil, but at the same time, not the what we have now. One of the good things when we discuss with others, we need to tell them, by the way, we have a big advantage as Muslims compared with our, let's say, colleagues in the Abrahamic religions. We believe in Moses and in Jesus and in their books. If you don't believe with them, we'll be disbelievers. But they don't accept us to join the club. We accept them, but they refuse. So if you want to use it mathematically, we have no problem. But with us, unfortunately, they don't accept our prophet nor our book. But we do accept their prophets and their books. But anyway, our point here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is stating that يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون. خلاصة الموضوع بالعربي يا أحبة إنه ربنا سبحانه وتعالى يمدح الآن من ويذكر الخصيصة الواضحة ويمدح أولئك الذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. طبعا لما نقول ما أنزل إلى النبي نتحدث بالدرجة الأولى عن القرآن، بالدرجة الثانية السنة. ألا إني أوتيت القرآن ومثله معه. When we talk about what has been revealed to Prophet Muhammad, we are talking about two levels of revelation. The literal revelation, which is the Quran, and the spiritual, or the spiritual, sorry, it's a mistake by me. And the other types, which Prophet ﷺ is guided by Allah, then he expressed by his, which we call it the prophetic traditions, or al-hadith al-nabawiyya, or prophetic sunnah, or as-sunnah al-nabawiyya. Okay? So both are basic sources, because Prophet Muhammad was Prophet Muhammad sallam in many verses he's stating قال سبحان ربي وهل كنت إلا شو الآية مين ذكرني فيها قال سبحان ربي بدايتها هل كنت ولا ما كنت هل كنت إلا بشرا رسولا. He is just sending. So we believe, why I'm saying this, because it happened, subhanAllah, just coincidentally, you know, the last few days, the person who was called Muhammad Shahrur, he passed away. You know this. For one of his deeds, he was directly and indirectly trying to demolish the Sunnah with a lot of others. And he wrote many books attacking the Sunnah. That there is no need for Sunnah. The most important is the Quran, which is completely against Islam and against the Quran. وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُوذُوهُ. What's the meaning of this? وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. What is the main aim of the existence of Prophet Muhammad in addition to conveying the Quran? It's to explain the meanings. 23 years of explanation. فقال يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك. عند الأنزل من قبلك نحن في عقيدتنا نؤمن بتوراة أنزلت على موسى عليه السلام وبإنجيل أنزل على عيسى عليه السلام ومن أنكرهما فقد أنكر ركنا من أركان الإيمان يكفر عندنا في الإسلام. لذلك هذه نقطة نعتز ونفتخر بها أن الله يأمرنا أن نؤمن، لكن الإيمان لا يشمل الواقع الحالي، لأن القرآن الذي أخبرنا بهذا أيضا أخبرنا يحرفون الكلمة عن مواضعه ونسوا حظا مما ذكروا به. ففي تغيير وتبديل، هذا ما أخبرنا به ونحن نؤمن بما قاله القرآن. لذلك لا نعتقد بأن النسخة الحالية هي النسخة الإلهية الصحيحة كما نعتقد في القرآن، نعتقد بشيء قبل ذلك عشان تكون الصورة واضحة. لأن بعض الناس لما يسمعوا هذه المعاني بيصير في عندهم نوع من الخلط. الله يأمرنا أن نؤمن، نعم، لكن بأي صورة؟ بالصورة التي شرحناها. طيب، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. الآن الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول فيما بعد هؤلاء على هدى من ربهم. I forgot one of the things. I forget to comment على قول الله تعالى بعد الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة. We should have commented on the concept of ويقيمون الصلاة. Allah did not say ويصلون. He said what? يقيمون الصلاة. إقامة الصلاة غير عن الصلاة فقط. When we say أقام الصلاة، إقامة الصلاة، we are not talking about إقامة which means say الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. The concept of إقامة الصلاة. Now literally we is it translated they establish the prayer. So when we Allah is praising the believers who believe, one of their characteristics basically that they are not just praying, they establish establish the prayer. As if he's telling you, we are talking about something huge, need to be established. It's like a building has foundations, you need to establish it. It's not something just the peanuts, you have it. No, it's something solid, very important. You need to establish it. If you do not, as if you are not praying. Here, I always would love to remind myself and my respected brothers and sisters, prayer, you know, in Islam, the only verdict, al-hukm al-wahid, or the only legislation that Prophet Muhammad received in the heavens is as-salah. Apart from everything else in Islam, كل الشرائع في الإسلام نزلت عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أين؟ وهو على كوكب الأرض. الصلاة لوحدها فقط أين بلغ بها؟ في السماء السابعة. بل في منطقة جبريل نفسه لم يصلها. You know, when we talk about the hadith, or at least what is authentic from hadith Isra wal-Mi'raj, you know, the traveling between Mecca and Jerusalem or Al-Quds, Al-Aqsa, then the ascension, Al-Isra'il huwa, the ascension into the heavens. This is part of our faith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, subhanahu alladhi asra بعبده ليلة من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى. Then قال وصل عنه ثم رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى وتحدث عن. Some of the hadith they talk that when Jibril عليه السلام was a prophet Muhammad, he was ascending, upgrading, you know, a heaven by a heaven or a sky by a sky, layer by a layer. We don't know the reality how. We have no idea. He used to see one of the prophets in each level. Adam عليه السلام, Isa عليه السلام, Yunus عليه السلام, Idris عليه السلام. He saw many of the prophets. At a certain level, Jibril عليه السلام, he stopped and he said, يا محمد هذا مقامي. This is the top of what I'm allowed to reach. Jibril, the archangel of all the angels and Amin al-Wahi. Jibril alayhi salam, he is the one who was in charge of giving the revelation to all prophets and messengers from Adam alayhi salam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Yet with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, according to our authentic narrations, he reached to a level where he told Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, after this level you can move, I can't. And by the way, in our faith, we believe that the best of the creation is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is part of our faith. So in that moment, after Jibril even, he could not reach more, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he received, you know, there was like a lot of details with that. On top of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there was some kind of discussion between Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Musa alayhi salam. It's not my point now, but nevertheless, he received the revelation of the prayer. At the beginning, it was 50 a day, then it was reduced to 5 times. What is the message? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praising those who establish the prayer. This prayer was revealed in the highest level for any of the creation in his relation. And it was 50, then reduced to 5. Plus, add to your information something maybe most of you know. Most of fiqh or sharia legislations at a certain time might not be applicable on us, except the salah. If you are sick, you can't stop fasting, you can pay the fidya. If you are not rich, there is no zakah in your life. If there is no security in the road, there is no hajj as an obligation upon you. Okay? If you are not married, you don't have the responsibility of raising the children. If you don't have a wife, so you don't have to bring the money and to spend on her. So in many cases, we might live life without applying some many things on top of Arkan al-Islam. I may go to the hereafter without going to Hajj or Umrah or even fasting or paying the zakah. I'm a poor person, no security of the road, have a very bad health. So 3 of the Arkan, not applicable on me. But salah, no way. No way. Male, female, obligation. Difficult situation, obligation. I can't walk while you are standing. You can't sit, sleep. I can't move my body your eyes. You can't move your eyes on your heart. The only way that salah will not be obligation, just when you lose your conscience. You don't, khalas, and you lost, you are out of your conscience. You don't, this the power of intellect does not function now. This is the only, you are not accountable. Apart from that, salah is an obligation. This tells you something about the importance of salah. It's not just الله أكبر سبحانه وتعالى الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم الدنيا كسر وذكر ذكر استعين سيد بسلام كل واحد الله صمد الله مسلم السلام عليكم السلام ورحمة الله الله. You know some people they pray in this way, especially in Ramadan, especially in the Arab countries. Maybe here most of the people, I don't know if you follow باب الحارة ولا follow NBC ولا كذا, بس the Arab people they are unfortunately, I mean in the Middle East, والله at a certain time. How many of you know about the stories of باب الحارة and Ramadan in the Middle East? Wallahi, about I think 7-8 years ago, when Bab al-Hara started broadcasting by the NBC, the people they started to feel upset if the Imam in the Taraweeh might take an extra few minutes and could contradict with the broadcasting of Bab al-Hara to a degree. It was told happened in many masajid, but this story happened in Libya, they say. The four TV channels, they were broadcasting Bab al-Hara, okay? It's a very well-known for the non-Arabs. Bab al-Hara is a very famous Syrian series which talks about a certain time of the Syrian culture at the time of the Ottomans and the French. And it is done in a very, very appealing way, very nice. So most of the Arabs, they used to, it used to be broadcasted on the time of the Taraweeh immediately. For some people, they said, one of the imams in Libya, he was praying the Taraweeh. He felt the people around him, and every time he says, Salaamu Alaikum, some people, they are looking, يعني يا شيخ خلصنا, يعني شمها, يعني please, hurry up. He was forced to say, يا إخوة لو سمحتوا, القناة الفلانية الرابعة بالبلد الفلاني بتعيدوا باب الحارة الساعة كذا. He had to remind them, by the way, this episode will be broadcasted on such and such channel at such and such time. Please pray freely and go and watch it there. Because most of the people are praying, they are thinking it. But my point was, Taraweeh, one of the best nawafil, we waited just once a month in the whole year, yet I'm talking about giving the prayer its right, when I say Allahu Akbar and I'm thinking about the episode. What kind of prayer is this? Nasallahu an. By the way, this is applicable to anything. If I'm from the youth now, Allahu Akbar, I'm thinking of my girlfriend. The same problem. Or boyfriend. On both sides, sisters, or Allahu Akbar, I'm thinking in whatever. So one of the amazing things we need, by the way, I'm not saying we should be like Malaika. We are not. Definitely, it's not easy. But keep struggling to do the best. Because this is the most important thing. Plus, another hadith. أول ما يسأل عنه العبد يوم القيامة قال صلاة فإن صلحت صلح سائر عمله وإن فسدت. It's like قال, what the first thing that the slave or the servant of Allah will be asked in the day of judgment is his prayer. If it's okay, if it's well done, it's like a glad tidings, good news that everything after it will be acceptable and easy. شيخ في حدا ممكن عشان تسكروا لي الباب مشان الصوت الله يكرمكم الله يجزيكم خير شكرا سيدي. اوكي سو إقامة الصلاة والإيمان بما أنزل قبلنا. Now let's move. And by the way, one of the things that I need to let you know now, I'm not trying to do the tafsir for every single word. I will try sometimes, maybe I will take like a group of ayat. This is the most important message in this, but not necessarily every single group. We move to اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون. إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. Do you remember when we started reading from Tafsir al-Clear Quran of Dr. Mustafa Khattab, when he summed up the most important message at the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah? He said it is talking about the main three categories of the people: believers, disbelievers, and hypocrites. Do you remember? المؤمنون والكفرة والمنافقون. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. ختم الله على قلوبهم وعلى سمعهم وعلى أبصارهم غشاوة ولهم عذاب عظيم. Now, what kind of messages we can't get? Now, Allah is saying, those who decided to be kuffar, they took a decision. Let's understand al-kufr. Al-kufr is, as a terminology, rejection and the denial. Rafdun wa inkar. Okay? Which means it's not they don't know. They know, but they don't want. Okay? They knew, but they rejected, they denied. It's like, do you remember, always I have to keep reminding you, the literally the kufr means al-ghita, to cover. Okay, literally covering something, anything that is covered, it's called kufr. That's why English, it was taken from Arabic to cover kufr. It's also, the origin is an Arabic word to cover in English. Yes, from the word kafara, kafara, ghatta, to cover. Now, this is called the meaning in the lexicons, bil ma'ajim, the original roots of the meaning. Later, now, covering, sometimes we cover for many things. We cover the food. We cover the things to keep it warm. And we cover things to hide. And sometimes it started to be used metaphorically. When I cover something, knowing it's there, but it's used for rejection and denial. It's like, for example, it's like my mom comes, for example, inside the kitchen and I have taken this piece of candy from the fridge. It's with me. My mom can, where is the candy? It's not with me. Where is it? I don't know. It's with me. What's this? Rejection, denial, inkar, I know. It's not I know. I have it. Now, as a terminology, this is called kufr. So, when Allah says, inna alladhina kafaru, means those who decided to reject after they knew, those who decided to deny as if they don't know, sawa'un alayhim a'andhartahum am lam tudhirhum la yu'minun. He's telling us that there is a group of people, they decided to reject, so whether you warned them or you did not, they will not accept. They have taken the decision. خلاص بدهمش ما بدهم رافضين سكر الموضوع. طب what's the message that I can take from this? You know what's the message, at least for me while I am preparing, so as not to be depressed or to lose your faith if, God forbid, you faced some people from your beloved ones who decided to become kuffar. What can I do? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us many stories. On top of it, the son of Nuh alayhi salam. يعني نوح عليه السلام, he's called from أولي العزم من الرسل. And Allah to أولي العزم, يعني meaning one of the best and great prophets, not any prophet, one of the top VIPs of the prophet. Allah says and told us about him that he kept on doing the da'wah. قال فلبث في قومه ألف سنة إلا خمسين عاما. 1,000 years except 50, which is 950 years just doing the da'wah. We don't know how he lived before that or after that. We are talking about the da'wah. 950 years. So he lived at least 1,000 plus something. Yet his son was one of the direct, clear, pure kuffar. And we know the discussion that happened with them. Allah put it in the Quran. قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّرْ كَمْ مَعْنَا وَلَا تَكُنْ مَعَ الْكَافِرِينَ قَالَ سَأَوِي إِلَى جَبْلِي يَعْصِمُنِي مِنَ الْمَاءِ قَالَ لَا عَاصِمَ الْيَوْمَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ Look, I don't care with what you are warning me. Oh, I will go to the top of the mountains. I don't care with your warning. قَالَ لَا عَاصِمَ الْيَوْمَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ Now what I need from that, Nuh alayhi salam, when he felt that his son is not responding to him, what did he say? قال ربي إن ابني من أهلي وأن وعدك الحق وأنت يا الله يا الله I know your promise. يا الله he's my son. You know the emotions. My son. يا الله. قال يا نوح. Then القرار الإلهي صدر. The final divine decision. قال يا نوح إنه ليس من أهلك. Now consider as if he is not part of you. Forget it. Subhanallah. Because Rabat al-Aqidah, the ties of faith is, has the priority. For, it's not for us. For Allah. And this is what he asked us to do. It's not our decision. إِنَّهُ يَا نُوحُ لَيْسَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ قَالَ يَا نُوحُ إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ إِنَّهُ عَمَلٌ غَيْرُ صَالِحٌ فَلَا تَسْأَلْنِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ إِنَّهُ your deed is something not righteous to ask me for forgiveness of your kafir son. It's as if in our language, close the file. Close the file. Your son. طيب, do you think I might be better than Nuh alayhi salam? أعوذ بالله. No way. 1,000 years of da'wah, yet he was not able. What's the message? Sometimes after doing your best, if the most beloved to you rejected Allah, what can you do? Nothing. Keep making du'a for hidayah, but nothing in terms of what? Don't stop, because it's not your decision, it's his decision. Out of sympathy, out of love, you have to care, but don't stop. It's not the end, because it's not your decision. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to convince Abu Talib. Ya ammah, qulha, ashfa'u laka biha, inda Allah, ya ammah, ya my uncle, Abu Talib. Please, just say, ashadu an la ilaha illallah. Just say it. I will do the intercession. I will use it as a power to protect you in the day of judgment, ya ammah. Qala la. Wumada yaqulu anni Quraysh, or nas. What do they say me? They say, jazi'a inda al-maut. Look, shuf al-arrogance. They, and they would say now, he was afraid when he was dying. No, I'm not afraid. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Ya Allah, what kind of arrogance is this? What kind of arrogance is this? Abu Jahl. You know, Abu Jahl, amazingly, he has an amazing story. Abu Jahl, when he was, you know, he took the first big hits in the Battle of Badr. He fell down, but he did not die. After the end of the battle, still his life was inside, but he was completely on ground. He can't move. Abu Abdullah bin Mas'ud, he was searching between the dead bodies. Huh? Abdullah bin Mas'ud was a petite, small size, very light compared with Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl like Umar bin Khattab, 2 meters with 1 meter. It's amazing. Because that's why Prophet Muhammad used to say, Allahumma a'izz al-Islam bi-ahad al-Umarayn, Amr ibn Hisham or Umar ibn al-Khattab. It's an amazing character, both of them. Very powerful, very strong, charismatic, very, subhanAllah. One of them decided to become a mu'min, the other one, he was the pharaoh of this ummah. My point, he's laid down, he's dying. Ja'a Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. And Abdullah Mas'ud was tortured by Abu Jahl once. Once Abu Jahl, next to Kaaba, Abdullah Mas'ud, he was reciting the Quran at the beginning of the da'wah. Abu Jahl came to him. He was very tall, Abu Jahl. Abdullah Mas'ud, very short for him. So he just took him like this from his ear. Then he lifted up. Then he cut his ear in his hand completely. It started bleeding. He went to Prophet Muhammad crying, you know, out of pain. Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And he was holding by his hand his ear, this piece of flesh. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam took it by the will of Allah. He put it in here, then it became exactly as if nothing happened. قال يا ابن مسعود أذن بأذن والرأس زيادة. He said, this happened before Ma'arakat Badr. Look, this is around third year in Mecca. Badr, second year after Hijrah, which means in the 15th. How many years? 12 years. This is from the prophecies, Nubu'at, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qala ya yabna Mas'ud, udhunun bi udhun wa ra'su ziyada. Don't worry, you will be compensated. Not just ear by ear, you will take the full package, which is the full head. 12 years before. Abdullah Mas'ud, 12 years later, he was to fulfill the prophecy of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah told him, he was looking between the dead bodies. He found Abu Jahl still alive. Look, he was very happy. He wanted to chop his as they, he came to kill him. His sword was a little bit small. Abu Jahl قال خذ سيفك خذ سيفي فإنه أمضى. He said, hey, don't use your sword. Use mine, it's much more sharp. Basically, when Abdullah Mas'ud put his foot on the chest of Abu Jahl, because he was, you know, completely lost his power, he said, لقد ارتقيت مرتقا صعبا يا رويعي الغنم. Wow. He will be killed in seconds. Then he said, wow, you know, ارتقيت, he said, he used the word called تصغير. Ra'i means the shepherd. Ruwai'i, you small shepherd. It's like a metaphor of looking down to you. It's hey, you are nothing. He said, you are Mr. Nothing, which deserve nothing. You have reached to a point that you put your leg on my chest. This is something you wouldn't dream about it. He was, he will die now. Look at the arrogance. Then a few seconds later, he, and by the way, he couldn't hold his head. He pulled it. Abdullah Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. My point was, I'm talking about why Allah is mentioning how the concept of kufr with this way. It's not just a philosophy. It's an attitude. It's a decision. It is an action. He decided, he refused, he's using his power against you to demolish you, to kill you, to whatever. So this is Abu Jahl. So my point was, if, God forbid, for whatever reason, I was facing someone who's dear to me, like Abu Talib to Prophet Muhammad, his uncle, or Abu Jahl, one of the greatest personalities in Quraysh. Ya Allah, we wish if he became Muslim, he rejected, what can I do? Abu Lahab, the direct uncle as well of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yet he was sparing his time 24/7 just chasing Prophet Muhammad when he was exposing himself to talk with the tribes to tell him about Islam at the beginning. كان يفرغ نفسه أبو لهب تفريغ تام full time job بس ماشي ورا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يمشي وراه. شو كان عمله؟ Just to ruin and to damage every single word Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to anyone, he comes after me and say, look, I'm his uncle and I am the best expert in him. He is a liar, he's a magician, he's a such and such, he destroys everything. Say, oh, thank you very much. Definitely, you are his uncle. You know better than us, this kind of cheater. You saved us from him. La hawla wala quwwata illa billah. That's why it's not just for any reason that Allah revealed tabbat yada abi lahabin. وتب ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب سيصلى نارا ذات لهب وامرأته حمالة الحطب في جيدها حبل من مسد. It's amazing. Can you imagine a special surah in his name and we are cursing him. By cursing him we are gaining أجر. Yes, can you imagine? Look how racism is rejected in Islam. We become close to Allah by cursing the uncle of our prophets. And yet some people, they say, you know, Islam is just a tribalism. It's just for Arabs. For Arabs? But this prophet, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, has a verse. If it's up to him to decide it, is he crazy to put this surah in his chapter against his uncle, the Qurashi? It's part of our faith. Prophet Muhammad said in the Quran, من قرأ حرفا من القرآن فله عشر حسنات. قال لا أقول ألف ألف لام ميم حرف بل ألف حرف وميم حرف ولام حرف. Do you remember this hadith? We said it at the beginning. So when you say تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب تاء با تاء يا دا three, just these two words, we have 70 hasana by cursing the ankle of the Prophet. So the tie is the tie for who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one of the things that we can take from إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. We need to know that some people regard this. I can affirm to you, assure to you more than that. And by the way, today we decided to make it 1 hour because it's holidays, or otherwise, let's go to قوم لوط, the people of Sodom, as an example. We have two places. قال أخرجوا آل لوط من قريتكم إنهم أناس يتطهرون. Look, the only reason why the people of Sodom, the people of Lut alayhi salam, they declare it, they did not hide it. They say, kick them out of your city or your place, your country, whatever. They are a people who purify themselves. They're declaring, they purify themselves, you don't want them. So have they done anything bad to them? No. But they refused to be but purified, so kick them out. The other evidence that you will be attacked even if you did not anything bad. Surah Al-Buruj. قتل أصحاب الأخدود النار ذات الوقود إذ هم عليها قعود وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمنين شهود. افتح قوس الآن. وما نقموا منهم إلا أن يؤمنوا بالله العزيز الحميد. The people of the trench, and it is said that the people that they were Christians, believers in Christianity in their time, like the Sahaba for us, like our brother Muslims and sisters. So the king of there, he wanted to force them to be pagans and to worship idols. They refused, so they digged a big trench and they made a big fire and they wanted to throw them. Allah says, the only reason why they were holding hatred against them, because they were believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's it. They did not anything bad, they did not attack anyone, they did not steal, they did not nothing. They are believers sitting alone in that corner. They will come and kill them. This is what the Quran says, which means don't think at a certain time, if you are a true believer, even if you did nothing wrong, some certain times and certain places, some people will attack you because you are just a believer.
In Turkestan right now,
yes. Look what happens for the Igor in China now. Nothing. They are tortured and killed because of their faith. They have done nothing bad. Type. Next message. By this message, I think this is a very serious, important one. I hope I have time to cover it. ختم الله على قلوبهم وعلى سمعهم وعلى أبصارهم غشاوة ولهم عذاب عظيم. Allah says that Allah ختم على قلوبهم. الختم التغطية. Let's read now. What is the ختم? الختم التغطية على الشيء حتى لا يدخله شيء. It's not just تغطية, not covering. تغطية, to seal something, to cover, to be sealed, not allow anything to leak to inside. This is al-khatm. Okay? Allah says, metaphorically, Allah did seal their hearts, which means they were covered to a degree that nothing will leak into them. طبعاً, فيه هنا possibility of misunderstanding. Say, ختم الله على قلوبهم. Ami, where is the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If Allah did seal their hearts, it means there is no opportunity to repentance. It's as if Allah is doing injustice. لأن الختم قال اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. التغطية على شيء حتى لا يدخله شيء، حتى لا يدخله شيء، وحتى لا يعلم ما فيه. وغشاوة الغطاء والستر، which means Allah has covered and sealed their their hearts and he put غشاوة and cover on their eyes, which means as if in our simple language they are not able to realize, to feel or to see. طب يا عمي, where is the mercy of Allah? Please freeze. Let's understand the following concept. This is the end result of a long process. We are not talking Allah. We said Allah, we repeat about the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 17 times, obligation, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Oh my servants, my place, don't ever be depressed, okay, from the to repent to me. All the gates of tawbah, of repentance, it's open. But here we are talking about what? Final result. Let me explain it to you in a very simple, simple way. So inshallah, we'll finish this concept and we'll finish. Now, most of us, subhanallah, we are living in Canada. We know, what's this?
Driving
license. You all know the concept of points on driving license. صح? Basically, this is full G. I think, how many points I have? 15 or 20? 15. 15. لا, full. I have 15 points. شوف الconcept. Now this is, طبعا الإخوة اللي معنا عبر الفيسبوك, نظام النقاط اللي بيكون في عندك على الرخصة لك 15 نقطة. كل ما تعمل مخالفة ينتقص من النقاط حتى تصل إلى مرحلة. الآن look, I have 15 points here. If I pass the red light, I might lose 2 or 3 or 6. Still I have how many remaining? 9, 10, 11. طيب, I have a double parking in a wrong area. 1 point, still I have 8 left. After losing 7, 8, they will call me, give me a warning, give me a course. Hey, where are you going? You might lose your right with the license. Be careful. I did not care. I made another, you know, offense. I lost another 2 points. Then they told me you are not allowed to drive for full month on any street in Canada. And this was withdrawn from me 1 month or 2 months as a, hey, be careful. I received it again. I insisted to pass through the traffic light again, knowingly. Then I lost another points. At a certain time, if I lost all of my points, no credit left, what will happen? This is will be taken and I'm prohibited from driving a car in Canada. Is this justice or not?
Yes.
If someone is looking at the final result, this pure man is not allowed to drive a car in Canada. Wow, how bad they are. Naam? Hey, did you forget what I did from the very beginning? They gave me 10, 15 warnings. Be careful, be careful, be careful, be careful. Hey, hey, hey. I did not listen. The end result, by the way, I was talking just about the points now. I have to pay the fine. And I might be go to the jail as well. Maybe 2 years. 2 years. 10,000 fine. Losing the points. No right to drive. This is the punishment, which is justice. Because I was given 15 points, let's put it 15 chances. When I lose all of them, it means I'm insisting on being a rude person with driving with this car. So therefore, the right of having a car and drive a car will be taken from the authority. You know this concept? This is exactly what we have to understand when we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يُضِلُّ يَخْتِمْ. Yeah, you see what I say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is misguiding them. Misguiding them, which means the final result. They have taken all of their chances. They rejected, rejected, rejected. They were very, very rude, khalas. They will have a new phase. Everything will be closed now. Allah will take them to the top just to demolish them, just to punish them. Khalas, their right in the chances is finished. So when we hear such as ختم الله على قلوبهم, Allah has sealed their hearts, وجعل cover on their eyes. It's not at the beginning, nor in the middle. It's at the end. خلاص. They have taken their choices, and no choices are left at all. Okay. Now I'm speaking since 55 minutes, so I think I have to stop. جزاكم الله خيرا. بارك الله فيكم. Tomorrow we will continue from اسم الله وصلنا سيدنا محمد. From ومن الناس من يقول آمنا بالله وباليوم الآخر وما هم بمؤمنين. لا تنسونا من دعائكم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.